Hey everybody, it's Invicta, it's time for another Solo Queue Simulator here on the channel. Today, I'm going to be returning as Rexxar on the Sky Temple, and I have got a build that I did not try because it was bugged, and this time I'm going to be trying it on the best map possible for it. The Sky Temple, of course, which I've already said before. On our team today, it's going to be Vala, Stitches, Sergeant Hammer, Tyrone, and Rexxar taking on Sonya, Chen, Uther, Tyrande, and Raynor. So, what build did I not do? This is going to be a great trivia lore question. What build did Sinvicta not do, or at least what type of build did Sinvicta not do during Rexxar week last week? That answer would have, and is a mercenary build. So, this is going to revolve heavily around doing non-heroic damage to non-heroic targets. So that means you're going to be going out to merc camps. That means you're going to be taking the bosses. That means you're going to be clearing creep waves super duper quickly, all while being able to utilize Misha's stuns whenever you do have to eventually inevitably get to a team fight. So level 1, I am going to be going for Hunter-Gatherer. Hunter-Gatherer is one of those talents that was bugged that Blizzard recently fixed, and I have not tried. I've honestly not played Rexxar since the patch hit, so I don't know what to expect. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to notice a difference in all, but I'm very, very excited about trying this build. Again, this was one of those builds that was really, really highly requested during Rexxar week, and I'm looking forward to hopefully trying it. I mean, it's I think I'm probably going to end up liking it. Get a Rexxar, there we go. We were able to land the spirit through Misha, still going after Tyrone. I'm gonna call her back and have her go right back up into the lane. But a lot of people were requesting. I'm gonna see if I can stop. I almost was able to save Vala there. Had I actually landed the stun, that's the thing. I'm gonna have Misha go take down that regen globe and then bring her back here. But a lot of people were requesting a mercenary slash lane creep build, and I chose not to do it just because of the simple fact that the talents that were involved, most of them were bugged, but this time around I am very excited and interested to see exactly how well it will do. So it looks like Tyrone wants to do middle, and that is fine by me. That's going to put me in a pretty nice position for the not only Temple Guardians, but also the mercenary camps. Get in there, Misha. Get in there, Misha, and get you some. There we go. So we're going to be taking down the Temple Guardians here with Vala, and we are going to be trading off one temple apiece, and that is fine. Choose a talent. I got level 4. This is a very, very big part of this build that is going to be Easy Prey. Easy Prey will allow Misha to do tons more damage, and I do mean tons more damage, against enemy mercenaries and minions. So it's 150 more damage. It also reduces the amount of damage that Misha takes from said mercenaries and minions. So I'm really looking forward to seeing how powerful this will make Misha. Again, remember, she does have the damage reduction as well, so I want to make sure that I keep myself out of harm's way, although for some reason this mob will not get off of me, so I'm just going to focus him first. And let's just see how effective Rexxar is whenever he does go for this minion build. And I'm really looking forward to seeing exactly how effective he is. I've seen some better Rexxar players than me do this sort of thing, against the team that I was on, of course. And I was impressed with how easily they were able to control the entire map. And I think that that's probably along the lines of what Blizzard was really going for when it came to Rexxar. He wasn't going to be the face hunter, stereotypical, throwing the traps out sort of thing hero. No, they want him to be the lord of the jungle, if it were, the lord of the wilds. He is going to control the map and every single aspect of the map, including taking mercenary camps, dominating lanes, bullying the minions out of there, that sort of thing. So I think that maybe I'm guilty. I'm not going to say maybe. I am definitely guilty of jumping the gun on Rexxar, but I think that I am going to be a little bit, I should be a little bit forgiven, given the fact that there were a couple of talents that were bugged, and hopefully this can be our redemption game. So we'll find out. We will soon find out. Level 7, I'm going to be going for Bird of Prey. Spirit Swoop is going to do 300% more damage against non-heroic enemies. That includes bosses, minions, lane creep, etc., etc. And let's see if we can get down here and just get as much damage as possible. There goes Tyrande throwing out the Lunar Flare. I'm going to stay on top of Jimmy for now. Jimmy actually took a lot of damage. There's a nice hook by Stitches, pulling him to Rexxar. We are going to be able to land the stun as well on Uther. Here comes Uncle Chen coming in from the side. And we're just going to pretty much let him go all face on Misha. Now, admittedly, I was not able to really get a whole lot of regen glows because I've been going after the jungle. So we'll have to wait. We'll have to wait and see if I'm going to be able to turn that one back around. Misha actually doing a surprising amount of damage on Uncle Chan. I'm going to back up and tap the fountain just because I am going to need some mana, and I really want to do this. I don't think I can do it without level 10. I think I might be able if I had full mana. I may be able. Misha, what are you doing? Get in there. I might be able to stop I might be able to actually get the skull golem down here bottom solo, but I definitely can't do it now that I've taken that much damage. So again, I'm going to use Spirit Swoop just to clear out the lane minions. You see they one-shot all the minions. I don't have the stun available for Stitches, unfortunately. I'm going to call Misha back, use the stun there. We were not able to get the stun on Sonya. I'm going to back up again. I really don't want to take a whole lot of damage from Toronto. Definitely do not want to get stunned by Sonya. Kimmy almost got there. Get her, Misha, get her. Oh, so close. We are almost able to take down Sonya. Jimmy is going to get taken out. Unfortunately, we're still not standing on the cap right now. And I'm going to call Misha back here to see if we can start contesting this. There's a missed shot there by Taranda. I'm going to back up. There's another nice shot. Follow up by our Taranda on the Lunar Flare. I don't know if I'm going to be able to actually get away, though. No, I am going to fall. And unfortunately, Vala was dead, and we just did not have enough damage there. Of course, Taranda can't really heal all that well, but I'm not expecting Taranda to heal me through a 1 versus 4, but if we get a kill here, that'd be nice. We are going to have our level 10 slightly before the enemy team, so that's going to be big. I am going to go Bestial Wrath. Bestial Wrath is what I've been waiting for. Can we actually pull this off and solo the boss? I don't even care, man. I'm going to try it. This is going to be the redemption guinea pig style game here. I want to see if I actually can get the boss solo. Let's find out. I am going to use Bestial Wrath here. This is a really, really bad position, but I don't even care, man. I'm just going to go for it. Go in there and get you some, Misha. We're doing a lot of damage to the boss already. And again, remember, I did use Bestial Wrath, so, and Spirit Swoop does a lot of damage. Misha already taking it down to just over half health. I actually almost got pushed by the Cyclone there. And so far, so good. Misha is tanking him not quite easily, actually. Even without, I don't think I needed Bestial Wrath here. Rexxar staying out of the range, and I might be able to just solo cap it. Uther's coming down this way. I don't know if he's actually going to actually see it or not. And we are going to get the solo cap on the boss. Look at that. Rexxar doing it live here in the lane, or out of the lane, rather. Let's go see if we can take down Uther here. And just keep him honest. I was able to clear out a couple minions. Made him use the. Divine Storm. There we go. And Misha did use. I did use Bestial Wrath on her, but I'm going to call her back. So again, I was able to solo the boss camp, which is insane, man. That was almost too easy. And I'm going to go right after the mercenary camps down here real quick because I'm already here. Easy peasy, so really controlling the map right now. The fact that you have a hero that can take down the boss camp by himself is quite advantageous, as that is a lot of resources that we don't have to that we do not have to worry about devoting to taking down lane creep, that sort of thing. However, of course, the downside of this is that I am not involved in any of these team fights, but I want to make sure that I'm still grabbing these mercenary camps as much as possible. That's the way that Rexxar is going to be supporting the lane here. And again, just look how easily Misha tanks all this. This is incredible. It really is. There we go. So I am going to be going for Wildfire Bear. Wildfire Bear is going to allow Misha to do continual AoE damage around wherever she's standing. I don't really think that Vala is going to need my help. We were able to push down to the top. Here comes Uther. We actually are able to stop Uther. And there's the stun. I did try to use Bestial Wrath here. Bestial Wrath finally does go off. Get him, Misha. Get him. There's Spirit Swoop. Can Misha actually catch up to him? Don't have enough for the stun. Yeah, we were able to get him. Nice job, Misha. Come back and get the regen glow. There we go. Great job by Misha. Also, nice follow-up there with the Lunar Flare by our Taranda player. And right now, that Night Camp is going to be pushing the bottom. I think Misha got tagged by the Sentinel there. The Sentinel shot, I should say, by... whoa! Merrick Rexxar, where are you going? Where are you going, Rexxar? Thank you, Misha. Here comes Crazy Uncle Chen, though, and I'm going to send Misha back, rather, just because I'm trying to get away from everybody. Going to call Misha back, but that was not the angle that I wanted to get accosted there. Misha, get back here. I'm trying to get away from the enemy team here. Misha just going to be sort of harassing them as the Banshees are on me. I am going to go back and get a full heal here. That did not go well at all. Face check the bush. Was not expecting to see the other Uncle Chen and the rest of the team come out from the other side there. Kind of a troll shot by Tirana, but she was able to stop me. Night Camp was indeed finally cleared out by Uther. I'm going to need a full heal and full mana as well. Just like that, the enemy team was able to catch right back up there. The boss camp going to be up in 2 minutes. Now they know that Rexxar is going to be looking at taking out that boss camp solo. I'm not going to be able to probably get away with another one that easily. Here we go. I'm going to send Misha right after Sonya. I'm going to keep her on Sonya just because I do have Bestial Wrath proc'd. And get him, Misha. Get her. Get away. Can we land the stun here? Misha. Oh, Misha got stunned by Sonya. Raynor actually gets taken out. Uther came out of nowhere from the top. Sonya actually was able to get away. I don't know what stunned Misha, but then Uther came out from the top. I had no idea he was up there. And all of a sudden, the enemy team is easily coming back in this game. What is the score right now? 10-7. I thought for sure that Sonya was dead there, but apparently not. There's a nice Lunar Flare. Nice follow-up there by Stitches. Here comes the Starfall, thrown out by Tyrande, doing tons of damage to Uther. Uther is going to get taken out. Chen ends up splitting in three here, and I think Stitches is going to go down, not before Tyrande gets a last hit on him. So there you go. This time around, I am going to be going for Primal Intimidation. That's going to slow the attack speed of anyone who attacks myself or Misha. There's a nice job by Tyrande getting the kill. That is actually Tyrande bot. And I'm sending Misha right on Tyrande. Stay on her, Misha, if you can catch up to her. I don't know if I can get the Spirit Swoop just barely out of range. We are going to be able to follow it up, though, with the stun. And that's going to be a dead Tyrande bot. Boss camp up in 30 seconds. I need to take down these Siege Giants before that happens, just so the enemy team cannot pounce on this. Look how much damage Spirit Swoop does. Oh my goodness. 1,024 damage for Spirit Swoop, and it's a piercing shot as well. That is insane, man. There you go, Michi, you crazy bear. Get in there. Sonya coming after me here, but I'm gonna keep Misha on Rex on Raynor here. I can't even talk right now. Nice job by our team, and we were able to take it with two of them being down. Actually, three of them being down. I'm gonna go after the boss here because hell, why not? Misha can definitely handle it, especially now. And can I get a second solo boss kill? I don't think it's pretty much a question at this point. Taking a lot of damage from the stupid cyclone though. Which of course is my fault, but I'm still not 100% entirely used to controlling Rexxar outside of Misha's control, if that makes sense, or microing him at least. But Rexxar getting another solo boss kill. Not even close, man. I'm gonna go up and take the enemy team's night camp here while I get a chance. If I get a chance, rather. I need to stay outside of the vision range of the watchtower here. I need to be very, very cautious, however. It's so much damage. I'm going to use Bestial Wrath here just to speed things up because I am pretty exposed right now. And taking this night camp, I got to be careful. Finish him off, Misha. There we go. We are able to take down the enemy team's night camp. Really controlling the lanes, controlling the jungle. You see the damage there, the AoE damage coming in from Misha's fiery warbear talent. And I know it's not called that. I think it's just called fire. What is it? What is it actually called? Wildfire bear. Something. I knew it was fire bear or something like that. There we go. The rest of our team was able to take control of our night camp. And just like that, look how quickly the map control turned around back in our favor. Most of the enemy team was relegated to trying to deal with the siege golem. And just like that, we are looking pretty solid. Need to make sure we don't get flanked here, but Sergeant Hammer can post up on Uncle Chen. And we were able to land the stun. Uncle Chen's going to end up getting hooked there by Stitches. He's going to go down before he can even get the ultimate off. Nicely done by our team. I'm going to be going for Spirit Bond just because. Spirit Bond's so, so good. And you see Spirit Swoop going through the gate, just doing tons of damage to the lane creep. And we're just going to push right on in here, right up the gut. I'm going to use the Bestial Wrath just so we can get a little bit of extra damage there on the temple, on the keep rather. Almost got the hook there on Uther. And with the temples coming back up, I am going to back out and go grab one. Would make the most sense for me to go take down the top right now, as most of the enemy team, most of our team is actually in the enemy team's base. Make sure I get that regen globe real quick. There you go, the temple's up in 2 seconds, and I'm going to take this one easy peasy. Man, oh man, I got to say, the amount of control that Rexxar has over the map now with this build is something that is truly a sight to behold. And I really wish I would have done this build a lot sooner. But again, to be fair, most of the talents that were involved with this build, particularly the level 1 talent, which is one of the most crucial ones, is were not working entirely the way that they were supposed to. Let's put it that way. There we go. I can't even see how many stacks of... oh, there it is, down there, 25. Okay, we're way behind. Well, actually, not that behind, but we're kind of way behind. So, I see Uncle Chan, and I do see Taranda there, but I think we are just going to get the victory. Our team's calling the GG, and that is going to be it. So, what a game that was. What a build that was, too. Final total, 20-8. Rexxar taking 2 solo boss camps. So much fun. Try out the build for yourself. Thank you for watching, everyone. Thank you for the recommendations for the build as well. Hope you had a great start to your Sunday, and I'll see you next time for more Solo Key Salinas. Until then, so long, everybody!